Hello, my name is Jay Khatri. I'm Director of Complex Coronary Intervention at Cleveland Clinic in Cleveland, Ohio. I'm really happy today to share with you my experience with the ASAHI Gaia Next series guide wires for chronic total occlusion intervention. This is essentially the big news. It's kind of the punchline for the talk. What is the difference between Gaia and the Gaia Next series? Basically, it's far more torqueable and far more penetrable. And we're going to go into some of the details about how this was achieved and why this is helpful for CTO intervention. So these are some of the basic features, some of which you are already familiar with, some of which are new. First of all, there's a microcone tip designed specifically to engage the lesion efficiently and effectively, and also to create alternative pathways to get through the CTO. If you think your initial path is incorrect, this microcone allows for easy engagement with the CTO cap. All of these wires have a pre-shaped 1 millimeter tip for convenience, and also this tape, this tip is pre-shaped to prevent any potential damage to the wire, and it facilitates very precise movements inside the lesion. It's typically the type of shape that you would manually place on a CTO wire anyways. The other feature, which we are all familiar with at this point with many of the ASAHI series wires, is Act One. And what this is a composite core dual coil technology, which dramatically improves torque response of the guide wire, as well as durability of the tip. This is achieved by a conventional spring coil with a second coil within the conventional spring coil, along with the conventional core of the wire with the second core applied parallel to it. So these three features we have in several wires already available. What's new now is X-strand. Now, X-strand is the iteration of spring coil technology, which has been pioneered by ASAHI. What they've done is a conventional spring coil that's applied to most coronary guide wires is now made up of a rope of many, many smaller wires. And I'll go through some of the details through the presentation. The main advantages of having this construction is the ability to avoid being trapped. So these wires are so capable of digging into a lesion that there is some danger of the wire being trapped in the lesion. And this reduces the risk of that. And it also reduces the risk of the wire fracturing in the event that the wire does become trapped, both of which are clear advantages over the current technology. This is sort of a long history of all of the iterations that ASAHI's brought to us in the coronary guide wire field. It all started out with Miracle-Gro wire, which was originally developed as a CTO guide wire. After Miracle-Gro, we got the Confienza or Conquest family, depending on which market you're in. This was developed primarily as a penetration wire, something to create a hole in the cap. After that, we received Fielder XT. This is a soft tapered polymer jacketed wire, which I think was initially marketed for retrograde, but many people use this to probe the proximal cap or to perform knuckle wiring. After this, we got the first guide wire with Act One technology. This is the ASAHI Sion wire. This is that super high torque response tip durability technology that is now being applied to many guide wires that we use on a daily basis. But the first wire in the series to have Act One was the ASAHI Sion wire. About 3 or 4 years ago in the US market, we received Fielder XTA and XTR. So this is taking the construction of the Fielder XT soft taper polymer jacketed wire and applying Act One to it. So now we have the soft taper polymer jacket with super high torque response and tip shape retention. Next we got ASAHI Gaia. So Gaia added on top of Act One, this new microcone tip to engage the cap. And then more recently, we received ASAHI Suo 3. Now, what ASAHI Suo 3 has is a new concept for the spring coil, which is constructed from a rope to allow for much more torque response and anti-trapping ability. And then the ultimate iteration now is X-strand, which is the ASAHI Gaia Next series. And we'll go through some of the advantages of this technology. So this is the overall schema of how this product pipeline has come to fruition. So what is this concept of intentional wiring? So the way that the wire is constructed is that it allows the operator to sort of feel the various composition of the plaque as you traverse a lesion. So as the wire is advanced to the lesion, the nose cone engages the plaque and digs into it. The wire is designed on purpose to deflect when it hits something very hard and calcified. So it's sort of similar to, the best way to demonstrate this is sort of like a watch bracelet. So if you have a watch bracelet, when it hits something hard, it can flex, right? That's the tip deflecting. When you rotate the wire, you see how strong my wristwatch is. You can't twist this. So the strength of the wire is in its torque response, but it's soft enough to deflect when it hits something hard. And you use that feel and the response on fluoroscopy to understand where you are in a lesion and how safely to navigate through. That's the idea of intentional intimal or subintimal wiring through a fibrocalcific plaque. And we'll show you some examples as I move through the talk. So let's talk about this a little bit more carefully. So the directional control is basically the torque response to the wire. So how easily is it to rotate the direction of the tip of the wire as you're advancing through the lesion? And the second concept is deflection control. How likely is the wire to deflect when it hits something hard? And it's these two ideas that allow you to safely traverse lesions in a CTO. So as this wire hits something hard, it deflects like the bracelet on a watch, it just deflects. And so now the question is, can you get the wire to redirect? And that's the torque response. And so this is that rotational force. So rotate the wire. Most of the strength is in rotating the wire. It has such exquisite torque response that even though it's wedged into a hard lesion that causes it to deflect, it still has a torque response to rotate so that you can point in a different direction. And then you can push again, and using the combination of deflection and rotation, you can navigate your way through a CTO. Now, this is in contrast to a stiff penetrating wire like a Confianza Pro 12. These wires are just stiff, and so they go straight. There's really no way to deflect these wires. They just basically go in the direction that they're pointed at. And this is a little bit more of a risky proposition trying to get through a relatively long CTO because the wire is going to take the natural curve of the artery and maybe exit out. So much higher risk of perforation because there's no deflection. It's simply push from penetration. So, when you encounter fibrocalcific plaque, the wire experiences stress, and the stress is at the very tip of the wire. And that's what you're looking for on fluoroscopy. You're seeing that the wire tip deflects. That's the stress of it hitting something very hard. And that's your indication that now it's time to change the direction. And thankfully, the wire has amazing torque response, and you're able to point the tip in a different direction to try and bounce off of that hard plaque. But hopefully stay within the confines of the vessel architecture. So the new lineup of ASAHI Gaia Next comes in a Gaia Next 1, Gaia Next 2, and Gaia Next 3. And it's the same concept as the original Gaia series, where Gaia 1 is the softest wire and Gaia 3 is the most penetrating wire, with Gaia Next 2 being somewhere in between. Now, interestingly, when you look at the actual stiffness at the tip, they're not too far off. So the very tip, the part that we're going to watch deflect, they're not that different. But as you get further and further away from the tip, you can see how stiff a Gaia third is, Gaia Next second, and a Gaia Next first. So Gaia Next first is by far the softest of the wires, even though at the very tip, they're not too different from each other. So let's talk a little bit about the microcone. So what is the advantage of having this cone? So as the artery is engaged, this cone can puncture into the lesion. But if you're not happy with the progress that your wire is making, what your cone allows you to do is to select out different paths if you're not happy with the original path that you took. And this is different than a conventional guide wire, which has a rounded tip on the end of the wire. So you can see in this cartoon, what happens with this wire is if it's in the wrong path, it's very, very hard to let this wire catch the correct path. It keeps sliding into the incorrect path. Whereas if you have the nose cone that's tapered like on a Gaia, it increases the possibility of engaging various pathways. Even though you created one pathway, the nose cone allows you to dig through and find different pathways. And hopefully find the true lumen distally. This is shown kind of nicely in this benchtop model. So this is a plain ball tip guide wire. You can see it kind of just sliding along the lesion, whereas in the microcone on the Gaia First Next wire is able to dig into the tissue and penetrate the cap. This model is, what we're trying to show is a 2 gram force tip load wire in both cases. And you can see how different the behavior is simply based on the design of the nose cone of the wire. And this is sort of another illustration of this in a benchtop model. There's a Miracle-Borough 6 going around a corner. So you can see it took the outside corner, and no matter what the operator does, that conventional ball tip wire always wants to go around the corner in the outside corner that it took. Whereas a Gaia Next Third, you can see how multiple different pathways can be achieved depending on which way the wire is pointed. So you can see in the beginning, we'll take the outside corner. And if you're not happy with the outside corner, you can pull it back and have the nose cone engage the plaque again and take the inside corner. So just a benchtop example of this concept. This is a real world example of this concept. So this is a real CTO that I did not too long ago, retrograde through a vein graft. So you can see a microcatheter at the distal cap, and you can see the distal cap is quite blunt and there's a bunch of side branches there. And what I'm trying to do is achieve a reverse part at this antegrade knuckle. And what we did is we used a Gaia Next Second wire. You can see in the right panel how the wire initially goes the wrong way. And then we can use the nose cone and the torque response to re-engage the cap and get the wire to advance towards the antegrade system. This is kind of where I think that this wire has really changed my practice. Whereas in the past, I might've taken a stiff penetrating wire to make a hole and then a polymer jacket of wire to knuckle my way up. Whereas now I can do all of this with one guide wire by simply engaging the cap with the Gaia Next Second in this case and walking my way towards the antegrade system. The wires have dramatically higher penetration capacity. Now, penetration force is a component of the tip load divided by the cross-sectional area. So if you have a much smaller cross-sectional area, by consequence, you have a much higher penetration force. So you can see how much higher the penetration force of this wire is simply because of the smaller cross-sectional area of the tip. Similarly, you can see Miracle-Borough or Ultimate-Borough 3 wire versus an ASAHI Gaia Next 1, the higher penetration force simply as a component of the smaller cross-sectional area of the nose cone. So the concepts are precise wire control, very good torque response, which allows you to redirect the wire after it deflects. The effectiveness of the higher penetration force of these wires to puncture through a lesion. And finally, the concept of safety. So these wires are incredibly torque responsive, incredibly effective at penetrating a cap. But once they penetrate, how likely are they to fracture or become entrapped in the lesion? And the ASAHI Gaia Next series addresses this as well. So this is just a conceptual illustration of the construction of the wire. So we talked about the Act One technology, which is the core next to a core, coil within a coil, the microcone tip. And then the last attribute that we need to talk about is this X-strand coil and what are the advantages of the X-strand coil. Ultimately, this was developed to reduce the risk of trapping the guide wire within the lesion and avoid the wire fracturing within a lesion. So what is X-strand coil? So basically this is a rope within a coil. And this is a tough concept to understand, but we all understand that a conventional guide wire has a spring coil on the outside of the core. What ASAHI has done is they have constructed their spring coil out of individual wires. So in this case, we're talking about, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven wires that are wrapped together to create the spring coil. Now, these are also made of individual wires themselves. So each one of these components has eight wires themselves. So it's a rope of wires that are wrapped together to make this coil, which is shown in this magnified view here. And that's in contrast to a conventional guide wire, which has a single wire, which is wrapped as a spring around the core. What's the big deal? So there's a couple of advantages. One is radio opacity. So this X-strand has components of stainless steel and platinum, which give you 15 centimeters of radio opacity. The coils that are in the Act 1 technology also have platinum components, which enhance the radio opacity. So it's very, very easy to see this wire, even in larger patients on low fluoro packages, low frame rate packages, which are commonly used for CTO intervention. But the biggest advantage, I would say, is the enhanced safety of this technology. So this X-strand coil is quite resilient and dramatically reduces the likelihood of the wire being trapped within the lesion. As we talked about before, the wire is very efficient at penetrating and navigating a lesion, but there's always a risk of the wire becoming trapped within the lesion. The X-strand has dramatically reduced the likelihood of it being trapped, or if it is trapped, the likelihood of the wire being fractured. This is just an illustration of how much the X-strand has helped with torque response. So head-to-head comparisons of Gaia first, second, and third with the next series, and you can see how much more the torque response has been improved using X-strand. And this is just another way of looking at that same thing. The X-strand coil has also dramatically improved the penetration force of these guide wires. So head-to-head, Gaia third versus Gaia third next, you see we went from 4.5 grams to 6 grams, and similarly with Gaia 1 and Gaia 2. This is a bench test showing you this concept of trapping. So the wire tip is in a lesion, and the lesion is compressed externally, and we're looking at a conventional spring coil wire becoming trapped within the lesion, whereas a Gaia next can be pulled out through the lesion. So you can see in the conventional wire, the tip actually breaks off and is stuck in the lesion, whereas the Gaia next can freely be removed out of the lesion. I think that most people who do CTO intervention have unfortunately encountered this scenario. This is a super high torque response wire, which was engaged in a CTO, and unfortunately the wire broke and had to be removed, and we started all over again. But this is an idea that hopefully will become more of a historical note rather than a real reality with these type of wires. Comparison of torque response, you can see how much the torque response has been improved. So the dotted line is sort of the ideal line of one-to-one torque response. And you can see that the red, which is Gaia 1 next, how much closer to the ideal line Gaia 1 next is compared to the original Gaia first. And similar improvements achieved with the Gaia next second. And this torque response is most enhanced in the initial phase. So immediate one-to-one torque response in that initial time of torque response input, you can see how from the gray to the red, how much more immediate of a response there is on initial torque input into the Gaia next series opposed to the historical Gaia series. So in summary, there's flexibility for better maneuverability inside severe tortuous lesions, very high torque response transmission to allow for precise wire control, improved penetration capability in tough lesions, and very, very high tensile strength as compared with conventional coils, which improves the durability and the safety of this wire in a very recalcitrant lesion. This is another just an illustration of all of the structural attributes of the wire, the microcone tip, the pre-shaped 1 millimeter distal tip, stainless steel core, the Act 1 technology, which is the coil within the coil and the parallel core system, the X-strand technology, which we talked at some length about, the hydrophilic coating on the distal 40 centimeters, the 15 centimeters of distal radio opacity. These wires all come in 190 centimeter lengths. This is just the catalog ordering information. So for Gaia, next 1, 2, and 3. And next, I think what I'll just do is show you some real world cases of patients that I've taken care of recently with the Gaia next series. So this is a patient that we did an IVUS guided puncture for LED CTO. And with an XDA, you can see we quickly got subintimal. You can see underneath this XDA, you can see the contrast of where we needed to be. And we think that we roughly deflected off the cap right around here. This is where these super high torque response wires are very, very handy. So this is a Gaia Next second, which we're using to engage that area where we had deflected. And just using the torque response and feeling and looking at where it deflects and doesn't deflect, we were able to quickly re-enter the LAD with very high level of confidence. I think you could have made the argument to have left the XDA in place and parallel wire this, but we were very comfortable with understanding where we had deflected, and we were very easily able to use the nose cone, the tapered nose cone, to engage this area of deflection, and then just use the torque response to allow the wire to dig through and find a path, and it very quickly freed up and sailed down the artery. This is another example. This is one where we did parallel wire. So this is a circumflex CTO where I think the XTA deflected off course right here. And so what we did is we just took a Gaia Next one and parallel wired. We simply engaged this area of deflection and used that same nose cone technology to engage that area of deflection and torque back and forth until we felt the wire pop through. And then before you know it, we were in very safely and efficiently and got this case done pretty quickly. I should say that on this case, even though we were through, we had a lot of trouble getting the microcatheter across and ultimately ended up having to rotablate this lesion. So it just illustrates you, even a Gaia Next one is strong enough to get through a super heavily calcified artery that is really underappreciated on fluoroscopy, but it was recalcitrant enough to where we really couldn't barely get a microcatheter through. This is the another recent example of mine. This is a very proximal RCA CTO where we tried at great length to get an antegrade system started and just simply couldn't. There was just no way to get an antegrade system started. And so what I did is I came in retrograde and, you know, it's a 2-3 millimeter CTO. And I thought, no problem. Confianza Pro 12 will pop across. But you can see on the left panel, Confianza Pro 12 having tremendous difficulty puncturing through. And, you know, this is what we were seeing on the antegrade side too. We simply couldn't puncture this. We couldn't Carlino through it. We couldn't use base. There was just no way to puncture on the proximal side. Felt similar resistance to the Confianza Pro 12 on the retrograde side. So we swapped out to Gaia Third Next, which is on the right panel. And you can see Gaia Next Third very quickly just drilled through and ended up in the aorta and made this case complete safely, even without a reverse cart. This is another nice example of a Fielder XTA in a patient in cardiogenic shock. We're doing multivessel PCI and had already fixed the patient's left dominant circumflex. Now we're doing the LAD CTO. And you can see the Fielder XTA after an IVUS guided puncture very quickly got subintimal. And we think the point of deflection is right here. And so I'll show you with the upper left panel, this is Gaia Next one at the point of deflection where there's a bifurcation of a diagonal and an LAD. And then if you look at the left lower panel, again, nose cone technology to engage the cap, exquisite torque response to torque through. At any point, there's a point here where the deflection resolves and the wire just frees up. And that's where it pops across this relatively short CTO. And then in the right panel, you can see we're clearly in the lumen and we just advanced the wire down distally and completed this case uneventfully. So these are sort of real world examples of where I think that the wire can be very, very helpful and make tough situations, provide some solutions to some tough situations and avoid the need to go subintimal and do EDR reentry, especially if you don't have a very healthy artery distally to do that on. The last point I'd like to make is highlight the importance of a system that has been developed by ASAHI to help train operators. It's called ETOS, stands for Educational Total Occlusion Simulation System. This is available from your local ASAHI rep. They can bring it out to your local area so that you can practice. And what it does is it gives you a hands-on opportunity to try various guide wires in various types of lesions. So you can practice on a 6,000, 8,000, or 10,000 gram type lesion, and you can try all the different types of wires to see how they behave in your hands in these types of lesions with or without a microcatheter, I think it's an excellent opportunity to kind of really understand what I'm talking about and what others may have been talking about in terms of what these wires can achieve. Try to do this at the benchtop before you put it into practice in a patient. But I think that these wires have really changed the scope of what can be treated and what can be done safely and what can be done just simply by guide wires without using more advanced crossing strategies like ADR. I mean, obviously, there's a role for the hybrid algorithm and advanced crossing strategies need to be used. But I think that these wires have narrowed the types of lesions that really truly require that, because a lot of these lesions simply be crossed with a good understanding of what these wires can do in various situations. So in summary, I would say the Gaia Next guide wires are optimized for active wire control. And by active wire control, you can cross these lesions both intimally or subintimally. The concept here is to understand when the wire is deflecting, that you can use the amazing torque response of the wire to rotate and redirect the wire and use a nose cone to create a new path. I think that these wires have improved the safety against wire trapping and fracture in recalcitrant lesions, very much enhanced penetration force. And the last point I want to emphasize is that there is the ability to train beforehand using a simulator to understand what these wires can do, so you feel more familiar with what can be achieved once you take your patient to the cath lab. And so with that, I'll conclude my presentation. Hopefully you'll have found this helpful. And please feel free to reach out to your local ASAHI representative to get some more practical knowledge on what these wires can do, and hopefully get your hands on the simulator.